I am standing roughly 175 meters away from the camera. That little speck is me. Let's zoom in so you can see me.
Flippin' physics.
When I whack this hammer against this metal pole, because sound at this air temperature travels at roughly 350 meters per second through air, it takes sound roughly half a second to travel this distance. And you see the hammer hit the pole roughly half a second before you hear the hammer hit the pole. This is the same reason we see lightning first, and then a short while later, we hear the thunder. The same concept is why we never see the moon as it is now. We see the moon as it was roughly 1.3 seconds ago. The moon is, on average, 238,855 miles away. The light we see reflected off the moon is traveling at 186,000 miles per second, or c, the speed of light. That light takes roughly 1.3 seconds to get from the moon to the Earth. That means the moon is, on average, a distance of roughly 1.3 light seconds away. When we look at the moon and all objects in the sky, we are looking at the past. In fact, some of the galaxies in this photograph taken by the James Webb Space Telescope are roughly 13 billion light years away. It has taken light 13 billion years to travel 13 billion light years to get to us from some of these galaxies. We are looking at some of these galaxies as they were 13 billion years ago.
Hold up. That means we never see the present?
What do you mean?
Everything we see is in the past because it takes light time to get to us.
That cannot be right.
It is. Even for the phone you're holding right now, about a foot from your face or about 30 centimeters from your face, the light takes about 1 nanosecond to get from the phone to your face.
I see my phone 1 nanosecond in the past?
Yeah. Everything we see is in the past.
Oh.
But I'm not holding a phone.
Right.